Okay, I'm going to do a response to Chris Hack, Westcountry Retro Collector. He asked 10 game-related questions, and I thought they were pretty good. One or two of them I kind of covered myself through my very recent Q&A thing, but so what? I like him, so I figure I'd do him. Of course, as always, I'm going to have the link to his channel in the description, as well as the video where he's asking these questions, so if you want to do it yourself, go right ahead. As I said, there's 10 of them here, and they're all gaming-related, so there you go. I also have them written, my answers written down so I can attempt to cut down time wasted. So we'll see how that goes. Anyway, the first one, which kind of seems like it would be a good addition for JL67 Gaming's Desert Island Games, by the way. Oh, it just seems like something to look into, I guess. It would fit. It's along those lines. Anyway, the first one is, you have to spend a year living on a desert island. Which three gaming characters would you take with you and why? The only way I could figure this out really was I was thinking practicality, like what they're good with and what they could, their usefulness, stuff like that. So the first one would be Solid Snake. He's very stealthy, so he could sneak up against animals, capture them for eating. But he's also resourceful, so that could be good too. So that was my thinking with him. Next is, he doesn't talk at all, of course, but he's very smart. He's a scientist, so again, he could figure out solutions to problems might come up, and also tools, stuff like that. And that's Gordon Freeman from the Half-Life games. Like I said, he doesn't talk, but he's very smart. He's the only scientist I could think of by name that's a game character, by the way. So, hey, he's a good choice. And last but not least, and this is probably the oddest choice, and it's the first one that popped in my head for this, is Dante from Devil May Cry. Then afterward, I was thinking Kratos, God of War, but nah, I was thinking Dante's probably a better fit. Now, the reason for this is simple. I was thinking, even though probably nothing crazy is going to happen in the desert, especially nothing he comes across, let alone in the real world, of course, but you probably should have someone that's kind of like a bodyguard or for protection or defensive, and he's pretty much all combat, so I thought he'd be good at that, you know? He could be the protector, he could be the defender. Now, the other two, of course, they're pretty good at combat too, but Dante from Devil May Cry, he really is only combat, so that would be his area of expertise, really. So I was thinking he'd be good for that. So those are the three characters I'd choose being on Desert Island with: Solid Snake, Gordon Freeman, and Dante from Devil May Cry. I think they're pretty good choices. Kind of strange, maybe. Best I can come up with. All right, number two. This one wasn't that easy, I'll admit. Sometimes I have a tie for this, but I went with only one. It wasn't easy. Second one is your favorite game console or computer of all time and your reasons why. Like I said, it's usually a tie because it kind of has the same reasons for it, but I'm going to have to go with my favorite game system, which, as I mentioned quite a few times, is the Neo Geo. And the reasons, other than what I've mentioned before in the past, is I like arcade games a lot. Always have, always will. Of course, it's arcade system. Even when you have the home one, the AES, same stuff you're playing in the arcade, which is one of the all awesome things about it. It's got a lot of stuff on it I like. I love the Samurai Showdown Spirit series, one of my favorite fighting game series. I really like the Metal Slug series. It's got a lot of awesome shmups on it, top down and side scrolling. It's got a really good racing game on it, Neo Drift Out. It's got a really good version of Bomberman on it. It's actually got a really good version of a golf game on there. No, I'm not kidding. It's called the Neo Turf Masters. And it's also got that bowling game I like so much that I shouldn't all that long ago, League Bowling, so there you go. It's got a lot of stuff on it that's really good. I like it a lot, and I find it interesting. And that's basically all the reasons why. I can go on forever about every little reason, but that's pretty much all there is to it. I just like a lot, you know? It's got everything I need for it, really, that makes me like something like that. Same thing with the other two that are kind of tied with it. All right, number three, which actually ties into one of the ones that's usually tied with that. Number three is your biggest gaming regret, and this is actually one I was asked during the Q&A. Anyway, same thing. It's the only one. About a little over a year ago, I had a bunch of stuff for the Genesis Mega Drive, not just games, and I thought about it for quite a while. I thought it was long enough, and I thought the reasons were good enough, and I got rid of what I had for it, all of it. And after a while, I realized it was a stupid thing to do. I shouldn't have done it anymore. That's all I could say about it. It's not like I can change it. It's a stupid thing to do. I shouldn't have done it, and I admit to it. And I don't want to do that again. So from now on, I'm going to think about it longer and harder, and I will make sure it doesn't happen again. Specifically with that one, because I don't want to do it again. I mean, some of the stuff I used to have, I have again. Not intentionally. Some things were intentional, but some things I don't have that I did, I could get again, just not as easy or even as cheap, so whatever. That's the way it goes sometimes. So you gotta go with the choices you make, and then you have to either, not make them again, or if you do, make sure you know what you're doing next time. That's about all I have to say about it. It was a stupid thing to do. I should have kept what I had. Oh well. So there you go, that's my answer for that one. Number four, which popular gaming franchise have you never played and why? It's pretty much because I have zero interest in it, and never have, never will, and I have no reason to play it now or never will. I never will, which is DDR, Dance Dance Revolution. Now, I understand it's not as popular now as it used to be, but it still kind of is to a degree. And of course, there's also that one you play on the keyboard on the computer, which is the same thing, you're just using your fingers. Same thing applies to that, by the way. Same reasons, I have no interest in that either. But there's only a very few songs throughout the entire, all the different versions of that I'm even interested in, I'd listen to, and I can't remember the names of them. I just see no appeal into it or interest. I'd rather just listen to music than do that, and I have zero interest in jumping around like crazy on these little square things with arrows on it. That doesn't interest me. I don't have the kind of coordination for that, and I just don't, do not, it's not entertaining to me. I don't see the appeal in it. It's no, I have no interest in it, you know? That's all there is to it for me. And if I was going to do it, which, like I said, I'm not, it would probably be in the arcade, because you can find those easy there. It's cheaper to play that way, and there's a metal base for the floor where the things are in, unlike the ones you get at home for the consoles, which, from what I've been told, you can break them pretty easy. So that's another thing. I never really appealed to me. But there you go. So for me, it's going to have to be Dance Dance Revolution, DDR, in all its forms. That's just me. I know a lot of people like it, even to this day. So there you go. Number six. What I should have brought one of them over here, I could show you, but whatever. Six is, what is your most treasured item in your gaming collection? At least that I still have or have right now. It's probably going to have to be, yet again, the Neo Geo, because I wanted one for so many years, never thought I was going to get one or be able to afford one, and I finally was able to get one. CMVS, MVS, and I have it. I even have a non-working AES, and even though it doesn't work, I like having it anyway, you know? Because that's closer than I ever thought I was ever going to have one, you know? So I don't know what else to say about it. I love that I have the thing a lot. It's fragile. I gotta be very, very, very careful with it because of the way mine is. But, you know, as long as nothing happens to it, it'll keep working. So I love the thing a lot, and I use it a lot. So there you go. Another one is the, that I said I should have brought over there to hold up and show, but oh well. My box complete in really good condition. PC Engine. Again, kind of the same thing. I wanted one for many years, not as long as the Neo Geo, but I never thought I was ever going to be able to get one, let alone in person. I thought I was going to have to pay the crazy prices that they go, you know, things are on eBay and import it from Japan, but no. I was able to get it in person at a place I go to all the time, almost missed it on the way out, saw it in the glass case, and I just so happened to have enough money that day, and I got it. So there you go. That I never thought that was going to happen either, but I'm going to have to go with the Neo Geo as the top one for this, as far as most treasured item in my game collection is going to have to be the Neo Geo. Alright, so there's that one. Number 7. When was the last time a game really impressed you? I'll tell you the most two recent ones I can remember. The most recent one is Super Mario Galaxy 1 on the Wii. Basically, I knew it was going to be good, I just didn't know if it was going to be a little bit better than Super Mario 64. And I rented it first, liked it a lot, so I ended up buying it, you know, the full thing myself to own. And it was really good. I liked it. I was worried that, you know, there's going to be tons of motion control in it and all that, which there really isn't. And I wasn't so sure about it at first when I was seeing the trailers and stuff for it, but after playing it, you know, it's really good. I went with that, of course, because I played that first before the second one, and the second one technically is a little bit better than the first one, but hey, that's really good too. And also how good they made it look on the Wii. So there's that. The other one I'll mention that's a little bit older is on the PlayStation 2, Metal Gear Solid 3 Snake Eater, which is actually my favorite Metal Gear Solid game and still is to this day. But, so that should tell you right there. But again, I was impressed with what they were able to do with it on the PlayStation 2, you know, using the hardware. They squeezed every drop they could out of it, really, considering some of the things they pulled off in that game. And on top of that, it's also how much more they added to it compared to the previous one, Metal Gear Solid 2, which that one kind of really underwhelmed me, as it did many people, but Metal Gear Solid 3 is just absolutely amazing. I love all the new little additions they put in it too, with the camo and stuff like that. How you had to actually find animals like snakes and frogs and all that you had to eat. Stuff like that. I really like the camo thing though, a lot. Big environments were pretty cool. And it's just the story overall. I like the whole theme of it. And also all the little trivia they stuck in the codex stuff, that was pretty cool too. Sometimes I had fun just playing the game to listen to the codex stuff, you know? So that's another one that impressed me a lot too. Anything back before that, and I can't really remember that much. I know System Shock 2 did. That one impressed me a lot. So that might be as far back as I can go. There are others, I just can't think right now. So there you go, there's three of them. Anyway, moving on from there. Number 8, how important is social media to the world of gaming? I just want to mention, I really don't care for how invasive it is these days. more than ever. You know, not just in terms of games, just overall in general. I have no interest in it, never have, never will, don't want any part of it. However, there is one thing it does in the world of games that I will give it full credit for, because it works really well in there. And of course, as they should and they will, continue to use it further going ahead, because, you know, you got to go with the times and make use of what you can. It does an extremely good job of getting information out there about a new game, release dates or something, or just a new game that's going to be coming out. You know, updates to a game, if there's a problem with a game, add-ons for a game or expansions, stuff like that. Trying to think what else, any kind of promotions they have going for it, sales. You get my point, right? You know, it's also good for one of us to do this kind of stuff, you know, videos on here about games. You know, you could put a quick thing up on there and you could say, I'm about to go streaming on Twitch. I'm about to stream on Twitch. That's a very useful thing too, you know? That is a very useful thing, and it's a very effective thing that it does very well. I will give it credit for that. That it does very well. Outside of that, not much, really. Anyway, moving on. 9, list free games that truly suck and reasons why. 2 of these I've mentioned many times before, but one I decided to throw a new one in. Anyway, Lotus Challenge on the GameCube, PlayStation 2, and PC. Not the same one as this on the Amiga. It's just a bad racing game. That's all there is to say about it. It's got technical flaws. It's dull. It's boring. It's not that fun. It's not that good looking. Cars don't sound that good. That's all there is to it. It's a lame racing game. That's all there is to say about it. It's not the worst one in the world. Next, Turning Point Fall of Liberty. Again, this is a technical mess, but it's funny for that, but it's just not a good game, really. Makes me laugh, but that's about it. Next is got to be the worst game of these 3 I'm mentioning by far. I rank it up there with Rise of the Robots, but it's only on the computer, it's only on Steam, as far as I know. Do not waste your money on this, I'm telling you right now, believe me, I'm trying to help you with this, don't do it, no matter how cheap it is. It's Bad Rats. Long story short, it's one of the cheapest games on Steam, it's also, without a doubt, got to be one of the worst games on Steam. For a while back, it used to be a joke that you would actually buy this during Steam sales, because it's like 99 cents, 29 cents. You would buy it for someone, gift it to them, because when you have a game on Steam, you can uninstall it, but even then, the name, it still stays on your Steam game list. You can still see it. And it was kind of like because it was a joke, it was like a black mark of shame that you had this absolutely horrible game on your Steam game list that you could not remove. So you used to like give it to people you want to mess with them, or people you didn't like, so it was stuck on there. You can get it for like 29 cents, 99 cents, and people used to do that. It's horrendous. It doesn't work well. It's a technical mess. Again, even I already said it a couple times, but it really is. I can't think of any other word for that. It's not even that intensive of a game, and it's pretty pathetic in every way, shape, and form, yet it can't run at a decent frame rate. It's weird. It's crap. It's really a piece of shit. And do not waste your money on it. I'm telling you, just watch videos of it on YouTube if you can even tolerate that, because it is kind of painful even watching videos of it, but hey. Anyway, his 10th and last question is, if you could own any classic arcade machine, which one would it be and why? I've thought about this for many years, because like I said, I love arcade games. What one would I get? Now, it's not that old, but I'm probably going to have to go with House of the Dead 2. I mention this every now and then. I would love to have House of the Dead 2, that individual arcade machine. I love it that much. It's my favorite light gun game, too, on top of that. But there's a couple other possibilities. Outrun, which I love that game, too. As many of you know how I am in racing games. I'm into racing games. Another one is Defender. Like that one a lot, too. Most of the arcade games I like are from the 80s. Those old ones there. Defender. Moon Patrol, which I really like a lot. But if I had to go with one of those, it's got to be House of the Dead 2, I think, even though it's not that old. So, yeah. Hell, if I have a chance to get it, I probably will. There you go. So, those are my answers to the 10 questions. Sorry, this is a little long. But there you go. Again, I'll have the links down in the description if you're interested. So, that's it. Thanks for watching and listening, and I will see you later.